That process is where we start capturing data around failure types throughout the entire product lifecycle, not just during an extended warranty period.
How are you using your data to help the merchants negotiate or create those manufacturer warranties?
Very good question. So, I mean, let's start with the reality, which is the majority of brands out there, when a customer calls in with a manufacturer warranty claim, they do one of two things. They do everything in their power to not approve that claim, and customers are pissed off, or they do everything in their power to just say, great, here's a new product to the consumer, and they just give them a net new product, and they do it at cost. Right? Those are basically the two buckets that I would simplify it down into. What that tells us is that the primary objective they're trying to figure out is how to either reduce cost or just streamline the workflow, because it's too costly to have one of their support reps try and figure out what's wrong with the product and then go through any sort of repair or replace process. This is especially true for lower AOV products, right? Ones that aren't thousands and thousands of dollars where there's a serious cost to replace it. So we are really focused today on optimizing the customer experience around those flows. What do we do for extended warranties? Customers call in with an issue. We adjudicate that claim, determine what the failure type is, what the problem is, whether it's valid and under the terms of the warranty that they've either purchased or have. And then we help them fulfill that with a replacement or a repair. That's the same exact workflow for a manufacturer warranty. Now, a manufacturer warranty is not a revenue driver for a manufacturer or a brand. So guess what? It's a lot easier for me to sell extended warranties to a merchant or a brand than it is for me to sell manufacturer warranties. But now people see the process. They see the customer reception and the high satisfaction numbers, and they want us to manage that manufacturer warranty process as well. That process captures the data that you're talking about. That process is where we start capturing data around failure types throughout the entire product lifecycle, not just during an extended warranty period. And that's how we start informing those insights for the R&D teams. So it's not a flip of a switch and turn it on and you have these insights available. You really need to buy into the vision of how do we want to deliver better customer experiences, both from an experience and post-purchase perspective, but then also from a product level perspective. And who are the folks internally? The reality is most people, especially the smaller Shopify brands, are not set up to even do anything with those insights today. Right? You need teams around product and R&D, and they're focused on how are we going to get our next order out the door. Much more mission critical issues than optimization on their supply chain at this point, right? Supply chain is just something they have to deal with. For the more mature brands that we work with, this is absolutely table stakes for them. This is how they make their margin. This is how they optimize their margin. And this is how they, in many cases, report to the public markets around where the company is going and how they're making improvements that they need to make.